Hello everyone, I'm Sam, a Huawei engineer. Today, I'll be introducing the basic networking of FabricInsight. With the rapid development of big data, traditional networking of data centers has evolved to cloud-based networking. Cloud-based services and complex networking impose new requirements on O&M. FabricInsight, Huawei's data center network analyzer, is introduced to address these requirements. Data center networking restrictions. FabricInsight supports only hardware centralized gateway networking, hardware distributed gateway networking, and host overlay networking. Connecting FabricInsight to the data center. The FabricInsight cluster connects to the data center through leaf devices to collect ER-span mirrored packets. To prevent service link congestion, you are advised to deploy independent leaf devices instead of using leaf devices transmitting services. The FabricInsight collector and analyzer are connected to the leaf devices, completing the deployment of the FabricInsight cluster. Outbound management is used to manage network devices in most data centers. For this reason, the collector is directly connected to the outbound management network to manage network devices. FabricInsight management scale. FabricInsight networking logic. The networking of FabricInsight cluster is complex. I'll introduce the data flows in detail based on the logical network architecture. Data flow 1. This data flow is used for reporting ER-span mirrored packets of the data center to the collector. The collector efficiently processes the reported packets based on the Intel DPDK technology. Data flow 2. This data flow is used for FabricInsight to manage network devices. Device status, topology, and flow mirroring are managed through protocols such as SNMP, LLDP, and NetConf. In inbound management mode, packet collection and device management ports on the collector are combined. Data flow 3. This data flow is used for synchronizing clocks between collectors. To ensure time precision of TCP flows, clocks on collectors need to be synchronized using 1588v2. Data flow 4. This data flow is used for data communication between a collector and analyzer. The collector reports the collected and processed TCP packets to the analyzer. The analyzer performs in-depth data mining, such as data cleaning and aggregation, and displays network and application information on FabricInsight. Data flow 5. This data flow is used for internal communication of the analyzer cluster. It is used for monitoring the status of each server, supervising the handling process of each microservice, and storing and analyzing big data. Data flow 6. This data flow is used for a user to access FabricInsight through a browser. You can view the big data analytics and presentation capabilities of FabricInsight through the service plane, or perform O&M on the FabricInsight cluster through the management plane. After the fundamental networking of FabricInsight is established, FabricInsight provides comprehensive reliability assurance to ensure stable running of big data analytics services. That's all for today. Thank you for watching.